Let's just say you're home alone. Suddenly, the doorbell rings. Water is boiling over in the gas stove and the phone rings. That's not all. The baby is starting to cry. What would you do first in a situation like this? What if we ask the same question to 10 people? Not all answers will be the same. People make different choices depending on what they think is important. Yes, we all have different priorities. Let's take a look at the control tower, which controls a number of aircrafts at the same time. What if several aircrafts call controllers at the same time, and all of them ask for priority, and there are no common standard? Controllers will probably give different instructions. As a result, the traffic will be a mess, and the controllers will blame each other. Don't you think standards are necessary to prevent these confusion? These requirements have created air traffic control priorities. Part 1. Basic principle of priority, first come, first served. Controllers often encounter a variety of complex situations while working in air traffic control. However, complex and difficult to judge situations don't happen every hour. In most normal traffic situations, controllers maintain traffic flow according to first come, first served principle. The aircraft that first informed the controllers that they were ready for takeoff will be granted permission first. The aircraft that arrived first near the runway will land first. In other words, the basic principle of air traffic control is to obtain permission in the order of aircraft that first informs the intention of landing or takeoff. It can't be more fair than this. Part 2. Operational priority. Now let's look into a more special situation. Which aircraft should the controller help first? When should a pilot give away to another aircraft? Under the air traffic control regulations, the following aircrafts must have priority. 1. Emergency aircraft. There is no other reason to help distress aircraft first. An instrument failure, bird strike, lack of fuel, an encounter with bad weather, etc. Not only these, there are countless situations why a pilot declares emergency. In such an emergency situation, the pilot should inform the controller that he is in an emergency and let the controller know the type of emergency and intention of the pilot. If a pilot uses the term Mayday, the aircraft means emergency. If a pilot uses the term Pan, the aircraft is not in an emergency, but it needs urgent help. If there is a pilot who uses words like emergency, Pan, Mayday, help him first. 2. Air ambulances. Every Monday morning, we all experience traffic jams, but what if an ambulance is giving you the signal there is urgency? You'll probably move aside so the ambulance can go pass through. Air traffic control should also help as much as possible with the aircraft's transporting patients. When an aircraft calls controllers using the term medevac, aerovac, or HOSP, it means air ambulance flight is in process. The patient's golden time is in the hands of the controllers. 3. Flights of search and rescue. What kinds of aircraft are search and rescue aircraft? An aircraft on the way to the place where the accident occurred, firefighting aircraft, an aircraft dispatched to the site of a nature disaster. These are all classified as search and rescue aircrafts and have priority. Every second of a search and rescue aircraft is like the life of someone waiting to be rescued. Giving priority to search and rescue aircraft is an act to save someone's life. 4. VIP onboard aircraft. The VIP is not just simply a famous person. VIP is a president called Code 1. The aircraft which the president is on board, the president's family, or their official entourages are on board for the country's official mission, have priority number 1. This is a scene from the 1997 movie Air Force One. Harrison Ford, who plays the president, manages to get out of the terrorist threat and is transferred to an Air Force transport plane. The pilot then notifies the controller as follows.
Liberty 2-4 is changing call signs. Liberty 2-4 is now Air Force One.
This call sign, which means that the VIP is on board, changes depending on which military the aircraft belongs to as follows. If a VIP is on board a civil aircraft, an Executive 1 call sign is used. 5. Flight check aircraft. What if the traffic light suddenly broke down on the busy road you drive? It is natural to feel uncomfortable, and this can lead you to accidents. Air traffic, which can't just stop along the way, is much more dangerous when this happens. Air traffic also has the same role as traffic lights. These are called navigation aids, which use radio waves or lights to help operations of the aircraft. Navigation aids need periodic inspections to prevent poor performance. The aircraft on this inspection mission is called a flight check aircraft. A flight check aircraft also determines whether a navigation aid is usable after repair work and new installation. Controllers are not allowed to designate aircrafts that conduct flight checks. Flight inspections are conducted by specially trained pilots using an aircraft equipped with special equipment. Since the purpose of the flight check aircraft is to prevent accidents, they have a priority for the time and route to check. 6. Air defense mission aircraft. What if an aircraft suspected of terrorism or entering the airspace of another country without permission was detected? Aircrafts dispatched to defend the country from them have priority. I'm sure you remember the September 11 attacks that made the world sad. How would the tragedy of the day have changed if air defense aircrafts had been dispatched earlier? This is why such missions should have priority. You would have fully agreed that the 6 aircrafts described so far should have priority. Part 3. Right of way. Now, take a look at situations where the aircraft of the similar purposes is converging or approaching the same course. In this case, it is difficult to easily determine which aircraft should be given priority. Just remember right-of-way rule in such cases. 1. Be considerate of the weak. Imagine a handicapped person in a wheelchair and your vehicle is right behind of it. You'll probably wait for them to make their way easy, without pass-through or honking. So, who should go first? Small, slow aircraft or big, fast aircraft? In the sky road, priority is given in order of ballooning, gliding, airship, helicopter, and fixed-wing aircraft. In other words, air balloon, powerless glider, an airship using the light buoyancy of a fuselage, and power-driven rotary and fixed-wing aircraft sequences. Remember that air traffic control also follows the principle of weak in number one priority. 2. Keep to the right. In most countries, people and vehicles should drive to the right. In the air, if the aircraft are approaching each other from the front, it shall pass through the right side of the other aircraft. In addition, if the directions of aircrafts are converging, the aircraft that sees the other side to the right should give his way. In short, the aircraft on the right has priority. 3. Takeoff and landing phase. Aircraft in flight or operating on the ground give way to aircraft in landing or final approach to land. In this case, even the aircraft at low altitudes is not allowed to intervene or overtake other aircraft in the final approach phase for landing. Also, aircraft at high altitudes should give way to aircraft at low altitudes. As in the case of taking off, aircraft operating in maneuvering areas of the airfield should give way to aircraft taking off or about to take off. What's the reason? Have you ever heard of 11 minutes of crisis? This is because aircraft accidents occur most frequently in 3 minutes at takeoff and 8 minutes at landing. Therefore, a more dangerous phase, an aircraft taking off or landing, is given priority over other aircrafts. The Air Traffic Control Service is the total sum of the decisions chosen by the controllers every minute and every second. The choice is not just based on the mood of the controllers, but only based on clear standards and regulations. If you're a pilot or a passenger on an aircraft, don't be anxious. The controllers will safely assign your order. If you are a controller, keep in mind which aircraft has priority. By the way, what would you do if you had to give priority to multiple situations at the same time? It's only up to you, the controller. Good luck with the priority you choose. ATC for you.